Hello, dear students. Today we are going to revise our chapter 3, that is tux paint. In this chapter, we had learned what is tux paint. They are the drawing program that is used basically for the children only, okay? That is designed for you guys, for the children, so that you can create your innovative drawings in this program or in this software. Okay, this particular software has a lot of creative tools and funny animations and the magical effects also that you can use to create your drawing. There are a lot of features available in the Tux Paint. Like, first of all, the most important, it's free of cost available. Okay, so you don't need to pay anything to use the software. The Tux Paint software has a drawing basket that acts as a guide. So whenever we are having any confusion, like what to do next, then this basket, drawing basket, is there to guide you guys. Okay. Then it have a lot of variety of tools and stamps, some personalized stamps, like a stamp of a animal, of a people, of homes, of trees, plants, and many more. Okay. Then there is a funny sound effect that is basically played by the mascot. That's a naughty penguin, okay? Then to load, we can load and save the images in this also, and without even giving a file name. So isn't that so simple? We don't even need to type a file name and we can save our file. So that's why it's very commonly used among the schools, okay? It's very simple to open the Tux Paint. You just need to click the start button, go to all program, and then you will see this Tux Paint folder. There are two or more options, but you need to choose Tux Paint full screen option so that the software will be visible on your full screen, okay? And you can comfortably draw your drawings. There are so many components. So whenever you open Tux Paint, in this Tux Paint window, you will see these components like toolbox, where you can see the different tools, then sub toolbox, the option which are available after you are actually selecting the tool. Like I am selecting a magic tool, and there are magic tools, right? And that can be visible in the sub toolbox. If you are choosing a paint, the different pattern of that paintbrush will be available in the sub toolbox, okay? So the further option is available in the sub toolbox. Then we are having color palettes, from where we can choose any color to fill in your drawing. Then there is a drawing area, the most important one, also known as drawing canvas. This area is used to draw your drawing. You cannot draw anything on your toolbox or in your sub toolbox, but in your drawing area, you can create anything, okay, using the different tools. Then this is the person who is a developer of the Tux Paint. His name is Bill Kendrick. He had designed this beautiful software for us. Whenever you open a Tux Paint, first, we need to take a new page, right? And to take a new page, when you are going to click on the new, you will see so many colorful pages, whether it's a black color, blue color, white color, so many different colors. That pages that you can see after clicking on new button are your starters, okay? So you can choose them as your background color, or you can choose any already drawn image from that, okay? So these pages which is available there are known as starter. After picking a starter, you need to choose one of the tools. By default, which tool is already selected when we open Tux Paint is the paint tool, because this is the most commonly used. And using this paint tool, you can draw anything on your drawing free-handedly, okay? You don't need to be specific, like you have to draw line or oval only. No, you can draw anything free-handedly using this paint tool. Then there is a sub toolbox. Suppose you are selecting a paint tool, and there are different patterns available for your paintbrush, and that patterns will be visible in your sub toolbox. And this component, or this part of Tux Paint window, is available on your right side of the window, okay? So you can see the options available for the particular tool which you are selecting. in the sub toolbox. Then we are having this haze brush tool. Haze brush tool is basically used to give a hazy appearance, a bit blurry appearance, so that we can see this object is far away from us. Okay, that's why we create haze brush or haze effect on our scene. Okay, then there is some magic tools in TaskPane. We can got so many different magic tools which we can directly click and use in our drawing. Few of them are bricks tool. Whenever you need to create a bricks in your home, then you can simply use this effect or tool, bricks. You just need to click on brick and then you can fill so many bricks in your walls. Okay, it's so easy. Then we are having blur tool. Whenever we don't want to show something, like we want to hide the face of the person, then we can use this blur tool. It will create a blurry effect, okay, so that picture should not be clearly visible. On that particular time, we use this blur magic tool. Then afterwards, we are having a grass tool. Grass tool is basically used whenever we need to create grass in our drawing. Suppose you are creating a scene of a park, then obviously there should be grass available in the park, right? So to create that grass, we will be using this grass tool so that we can create green grass in our scene. Okay, and make sure this grass is available only in green color. There are different shades of green is available, but you cannot draw grass of red or black color. Okay, then we are having fill tool. Whenever you need to fill different colors in your drawing, you need to use this fill tool. Using this, you can fill any color from the color palette to your drawing. Okay, it's same as fill with the color tool available in the MS Paint, but here its name is fill tool and it's available under magic tool. Okay, then we are having flower tool. Same as grass tool, we are having this flower tool. Using this particular tool, you can create different flowers, and not like grass only green color, but flowers we can create of different colors. You can choose any color and of that color you can create a flower. Okay, like red, yellow, blue, green, or any other. Fine. Then we are having stamp tool. Stamps are like the stickers. Are you getting? See, whenever we are getting stickers, we can easily paste it on our walls, on our hands, on our books, or on our tiffins, right? So similarly, we are getting the stamps. Stamps are like the ready-made stickers that we can just paste in our drawing. And there are different stamps available in the TaskPane. For example, stamp of a man, of a tree, of an animal, then stamp of a planet, and so much more. Okay? So you can just take the stamp and then you can paste it in your drawing. You don't need to draw the whole stamp. You can just click and paste. That's it. Then we are having this pattern brush tool. Pattern brush tool is used. It's basically to use this, we just need to click the paint tool only. And there are, as I told you, there are different options available in the paint tool also. That can be seen in the sub toolbox, right? So these are the patterns actually. So that pattern brush tool means you are using the paint tool, but you are not using the simple paint tool, not the simple brush. You are using some patterns like leaves pattern to draw the leaves on the tree, right? So these kind of patterns when we are using and we are selecting paint tool, then it's known as pattern brush tool. Then we are having line. The patterns available in the paint tool and in the line tool are exactly same. The only difference is when you are using paint tool, you can use that pattern free-handedly. But when you are using line tool, you have to draw that pattern in a straight lines only. You can't draw freehand, okay? So that's the only difference. Then how to save a file? Not like MS Paint or MS Word, you need to click on save button and then you have to type the name and you have to choose the location. Not at all. In TaskPane, it's so quick and so easy. How? You just need to click save button. That's it. No need to give the location. No need to give the file name. Nothing. Just click on the save button and your drawing is saved. Then how to open your saved drawing? As I told you, here location and name is not required. So just click on open button and then you can see a lot of images that you have already saved. So you just need to click that you want to open and there will be an open button available on that window also. So click on that open button and you can see that saved file will be opened on your screen. It's that simple. I hope you have understood this chapter. Make sure you are going to revise it also. Thank you.